Hey, hello guys, this is Viren Kumar and welcome back. So today in this video session, I'm going to talk about the Firebug and the Firepath. Those are very helpful tools available for the web developers and the web designers and both and also for the automation engineers. And we know that the Firebug was the add-ons of the Mozilla Firefox. We can integrate this Firebug and the Firepath to the Mozilla Firefox, and after that we can easily inspect an HTML elements and we can modify the designs directly into the browser. But now the problem was that after taking the update of the new version of the Firefox above the 56, the Firebug add-ons was not working. That means the Firebug and the Firepath are not supporting into the latest version of the Firefox. That was the older problem. But now the big problem is that the Firebug and the Firepath is completely removed from the Mozilla Firefox as add-ons. That means we cannot install or we cannot add these Firebug and the Firepath to any version of the Mozilla Firefox in the future, because the Firebug is not maintained by the company and it's completely disabled from the Mozilla Firefox. So this is a big problem for the automation engineers, because we are using this Firebug to locate a web element on the web page, and easily we can write the relative XPath, and it was really very helpful tool for the automation engineers. Those are working into the Selenium with the web applications. So if you are the newcomers and if you are freshers and if you want to learn the Selenium, then it is a big problem for you to write the XPath, or it is big problem to locate a web element on the web application using the Mozilla Firefox. So this is the my Mozilla Firefox, and this is the older version. It's around 46. And I already have this Mozilla Firebug. It looks like that, and this is the Firebug and this is the Firepath. So using these both ones in the Mozilla Firefox, I can easily locate a web element and I can easily write the relative XPath for my web element on this web page. But now if you are going to install and if you are going to upgrade your Mozilla Firefox, then it will not available as an add-ons in the Mozilla Firefox. What is the alternate solutions and what are the steps we can follow? So I'm going to talk about all these steps. The first thing is that you just make sure that you are disable the update into your Firefox. So for that, you just go to the Firefox options. You just click here and then go to the options. After these options, you come to the advanced, and here you just click on the update, and here just make sure never check for updates, and along with that you just uncheck this user background service to install the updates. This steps is for the person those are already using the Mozilla Firefox and those are already having this Firebug and the Firepath as add-ons in the Mozilla. So if you have already, then it is not a problem for you. You can use it, but make sure you should not update your Mozilla Firefox. So disable all the update a checkbox into the Mozilla. I'm going to search that Firebug for Mozilla. So if you hit enter and then here you will get this link, Firebug, get the extension for the Firefox. If you click on this one, it will navigate to you. In this link, it will show the page not found link. Sorry, but we cannot find anything at the address. That means you will not get the add-ons for the Firebug and the Firepath. And this is the big problem for all the browsers, not only the latest version of the Mozilla Firefox. So there are so many articles you can see here. They have completely said goodbye to the Firebug into the Mozilla. So this is the like article they have given saying goodbye to the Firebug. That means they have said goodbye to the Firebug and they are not supporting the Firebug. But anyway, if you are experienced and if you know that what are the XPath functions, contents functions and text function and other. So in the Chrome we have one add-ons. The name of this add-ons is like this is XPath helper. We can say this is a relative XPath helper add-on for the Chrome. This is the Chrome. So your relative XPath helper for the Chrome Web Store, and I will show that how you can use the relative XPath helper. So you just click on this link and it will navigate to the add-ons for the Chrome and just add to the Chrome and here add extension. So you can relative XPath helper has been added to the Chrome. So now how to use this XPath helper? So just restart your Chrome and so whatever website you want to automate, you just provide the link for this one, your website name, and after that here you can see this link relative XPath helper. So you just click on this link. So here you can see like this. So suppose that I want to locate this Google search, right click on this one and it will write the relative XPath for you. So this is the like tool generated relative XPath, and if you want to modify, you just copy this XPath and paste it here and just hit enter. So it will give you the element that you want to locate. And if you want to modify this relative XPath, then easily you can modify, like you want to add this contents. So contents function, so you just give the contents and you can write the contents function for this one. This is only for the experienced person. Those are aware of or the contents function and the text functions, and it will locate your web element if I give like this. So it will not, no results found. That means the contents function is working, and if I remove all these things, so it will locate the web element. So this is the way by which we can write the relative XPath for our web applications. In the Selenium.